Very good morning to you. And Queensland residents are rushing to clean up damage from a major storm cell that lashed the southeast. And we're being warned the worst could be to come. Let's take you live to Today Queensland reporter Mia Glover, who's in Logan. Mia, there's major damage where you are.
Yeah, there certainly is, Ali. Good morning again to you. This tree is still cutting off residents here at Lennox Court in Logan this morning. But now the sun is up, you can get a feeling of exactly what residents went through late yesterday afternoon. This is a young family's home. They were inside when their roof was ripped off during that tornado, a storm-like cell, which ripped through Logan yesterday, cutting power to almost 30,000 homes and properties. The Bureau of Meteorology says it is another heat wave today and more storms are on the way.
We are expecting another round of severe thunderstorms with heavy to intense rainfall and even flash flooding as well for those across Brisbane, the Gold Coast and right up through central Queensland.
The humidity is already stifling here in Logan this morning, Ali. The feel-like temperature is around 29 and a half degrees already. Those storms that are predicted this afternoon, they will be fast, they will be ferocious, but they will cool things down later tonight. Ali?
Thanks, Mia.
A huge loss for the music industry this morning. Legendary icon Glenn Wheatley sadly passing away from COVID, aged 74. Let's bring in Christine Ahern, who's in Melbourne for us this morning. Chris, how is he being remembered this morning?
Carl, he is being remembered fondly by those that knew him and worked with him. He did begin his career on stage as a bass guitarist in the 60s for rock band The Masters Apprentices, and they have taken to Facebook to pay tribute, saying, "We're deeply saddened by the passing of Glenn Wheatley. He's left his mark forever on Australian music. We will miss him greatly." He went on to manage the Little River Band, later Delta Goodrum, but he will be remembered forever for his enduring partnership with John Farnham, famously mortgaging his house in the 80s to finance the hugely popular album Whispering Jack. Here is friend and music journalist Glenn A. Baker.
He will be seen, as in fact Michael Gudinski is seen, as being one of the masters of the Australian music industry.
He contracted COVID around Christmas, spending weeks in a Melbourne hospital. He leaves behind his wife, Gaynor, and three children. He managed John Farnham until the very end. Carl.
I love with all of them this morning. Chris, thank you.
The Prime Minister is under pressure this morning after damning text messages allegedly written by Gladys Berejiklian were leaked.
She describes you as, quote, a horrible, horrible person, going on to say she did not trust you, and you're more concerned with politics than people.
I obviously don't agree with it, and I don't think that's my record.
And Ali will be speaking to the Prime Minister live on the show in the next 5 minutes. The COVID crisis in our aged care homes is worsening, with fears 1 in 10 residents aren't boosted. Today, correspondent Lara Vella is at an aged care home in Western Sydney for us today. Lara, good morning. This is a big concern for the aged care industry.
It sure is, Alex. In fact, one infectious diseases expert described the entire aged care sector across the country as sacred spaces. And so everyone that works in them and that lives in them should be adequately protected. But right now, Alex, it seems that is not the case, particularly in certain circumstances here in New South Wales. The aged care sector says this is due to a few factors, including a sudden increase in outbreaks, particularly when those booster programs started, and also staff shortages. In fact, according to one aged care worker that we also spoke to on Today on Nine a little earlier, she's described the entire sector, Alex, as drowning and says that she spent weeks trying to secure her third dose.
With the booster injection, we were left to make our own appointments, so look for our own booster injections. And it's quite hard when people are working full time.
Alex, all this comes as New South Wales continues to lag behind other states in the uptake of the booster doses, sitting at just below 40%.
Lara, thank you. Victoria's elective surgery ban could be lifted as soon as next week as the hospital admissions drop. The Age reports private hospitals are expected to restart treatments at 50% of pre-pandemic levels. It comes as New South Wales prepares to resume elective surgery from February 7. Russian President Vladimir Putin says the Kremlin's fundamental concerns have been ignored in his first comments on the crisis at the Ukraine border. Putin says he hopes dialogue on Ukraine will continue in order to avoid negative scenarios, including war. And this is the stuff of nightmares, as British Airways jet had a near miss when the pilot was forced to abort a landing attempt at Heathrow Airport. Winds. Footage shows the plane almost toppling onto its side. Let's have another look at it. The pilot managed to steady the jet and pull it up before flying off for another landing attempt.
Gee, that would have been hard for Dickie to control his gin and tonic.
He would have held it.
He's a professional. Not even that.
He's experienced.
It would have remained upright the entire time.
Carl.
Almost half of Australia's aged care facilities are right now battling COVID outbreaks, with staff completely overworked and unboosted residents making up the bulk of our nation's growing death toll. To get a clearer idea of the situation, let's bring in aged care nurse Jocelyn Hoffman, who joins us now from Hazelbrook in the Blue Mountains. So, Jocelyn, thank you for your time this morning. Fortunately, the facility you work at isn't in lockdown, but how is COVID impacting staff and your residents?
I'll describe it this way, Carl. Before the COVID pandemic hit our shores, we were already treading water. Across Australia, or aged care workers are under a lot of heavy workload, chronic understaffing, and now that the COVID pandemic's hit, we're drowning and we're left with our own devices. It's really, really hard out there.
How are you going
in aged care facilities across Australia?
It sure is. How are you going with the booster rollout?
With the booster rollout. When we had our COVID vaccinations, there was a clinic at work who assisted with giving everyone their vaccinations. But with the booster injection, we were left to make our own appointments, so look for our own booster injections. And it's quite hard when people are working full time. But we're left on that too.
Jocelyn, what do you mean? I'm sorry to interrupt. That's shocking to me. What do you mean you had to find your own?
Like ring around and look for your own booster vaccination. So it's taken us, my husband and I, a few weeks to get our own. So I just had mine last Friday. We had to wait.
Right.
There wasn't enough stock when we made the appointment.
So this is only adding to your burden inside. You must be pretty exhausted at the moment. What's the biggest problem? What's the biggest issue you're facing?
Well, the biggest issue, we've already had such a heavy workload in the past, but with the COVID pandemic hitting residential aged care facilities, on top of that heavy workload, we, as a registered nurse, I do COVID screening on the afternoon staff, because I work in the afternoon.
Yeah.
And also the visitors who come in. And also, most importantly, is we also... I, as the registered nurse, do COVID screening on residents, so monitor their temperatures, document that, and also be mindful and watch for any COVID symptoms that we observe from my residents.
Jocelyn, I can't imagine how difficult things are for you right now. But can you answer this for me? Will the Prime Minister's promise of say $400 payments, will that ease the burden a little?
It's really a joke because this one, by the time you pay taxes, say maybe just $100 will reach our pockets, but that's not the issue. The issue is to fix up the foundation of aged care. Start with the aged care workers, improve the working conditions, attract more workers in aged care because we're suffering. That money is just a vote buying exercise.
Look, I can feel your pain this morning.
It won't fix aged care.
Yeah, thank you so much for being with us and for talking publicly about this, which is difficult for you to do. I appreciate you doing that and letting our audience know how you're faring there. Thank you.